Today, we're taking a look at David Fincher and Tim Miller's new Netflix animated anthology series, Love, Death, and Robots. Damn, that's a great name.
Hear the music.
Comprised of 18 episodes, each animated by a different crew from around the world, Love, Death, and Robots is a visual feast that will make your nerd heart swoon. Originally intended to be a reboot of the heavy metal animated movie. Wait, you've never heard of heavy metal? Heavy metal, originally known as Metal Hurlant, was a French science fiction and fantasy magazine featuring work from various French comic book artists. Most notably among them, Mobius. Yes, the same Mobius that would go on to help Ridley Scott with Alien, Blade Runner, and Legend. Metal Hurlant would later be licensed by publisher Leonard Mogul of National Lampoon fame and renamed Heavy Metal in America. The magazine grew in popularity and in 1981 was adapted to film from several of the magazine's awesome serials. To say heavy metal was influential would be an understatement, and if you need further proof, just take a look at Luc Besson's Fifth Element.
You know what? Imitation is the most sincere form of flattery, so I thank you.
In 2008, David Fincher, director of Seven and Fight Club, along with Tim Miller, co-founder of Blur Studios and director of Deadpool, were working on a heavy metal reboot with Paramount Pictures. Sadly, Fincher couldn't get the movie funded, and in 2011, director of Battle Angel Alita, Robert Rodriguez, acquired the rights. This forced Fincher and Miller to evolve their original concept, and 8 years later, voila, we have Love, Death, and Robots, thanks to Fincher and Miller's passion, and Netflix's willingness to take a risk. Before you go, don't forget to hit the like and smash that subscribe button. And if you really like what you saw, tell your friends. See you next time. Oh, and remember, always be you. At least that's what everyone tells me.